Good morning, students, and welcome back again. Today we are going to start a new chapter in biology, that is chapter 11, transportation in animals and plants. First we need to know what do you mean by transport. Transport kisko kahenge? We know that all living organism, whether it is plant or animals, needs food, water and oxygen to survive. Lekin ye sara substance ko needs to be delivered to their body parts so that they can function properly. In one word, transport ka matlab kya ho raha hai? Koi bhi cheez ko jab ek jagah se dusra jagah tak hum lekar ja rahe, transfer kar rahe, usko hum log kya bolte hai? Transport. So all living organisms, they need food, water and oxygen for their survival, and these substances need to be transported to each and every parts of the body so that they can function properly. Hence, all living organism, they require a transport system. Ek transport system chahiye taki sare substances ko wo transport kar paaye. In this chapter, we will mainly focus on the human circulatory system. हम लोग बहुत सारे सिस्टम के बारे में पढ़ कर आ चुके हैं कि हम लोग का बॉडी में क्या क्या सिस्टम है. वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. सो सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन बॉडी. इट इज अ ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम ऑफ द ह्यूमन बॉडी. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ नेटवर्क दैट सप्लाइज फूड, ऑक्सीजन, वाटर एंड अदर सब्सटेंसेस थ्रू आउट द बॉडी. So human circulatory system is a one type of transport system that transport substances to different parts of the body. Now this human circulatory system mainly consists of three things. First is the blood, second heart, and the third one is blood vessels. First, let's discuss the first component, that is what? Blood. We will discuss about blood and its different components. So what is blood? Blood is a red fluid that runs throughout our entire body through a network of tube-like structure which is called as blood vessels. Let's see what are the different components of blood. First one is the plasma, next red blood cell RBC, WBC white blood cell, and platelets. Let's discuss the first component, that is plasma. Plasma is the liquid part of the blood. The fluid part of the blood is the plasma. It is yellow colored. The color of plasma is basically yellow in color. It 90% of plasma consists of water and it carries nutrients, different blood cells and hormones throughout the body. Next component of blood is RBC or red blood cell. The color of the blood is red due to the presence of a pigment which is called as what? Hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is responsible for red color of the blood. Hemoglobin transports oxygen to different parts of the body. This is the function of RBC. Next is WBC or white blood cell. So what are white blood cells? White blood cells defends against infectious diseases. It kills the germs that enters our body and protects our body from diseases. So WBC fight with the germs and kills them. So this is the function of what? This is the function of WBC. Next comes what? Platelets. You must have noticed that each time you get injury and bleed, the bleeding stops after some time by itself. This is due to the presence of platelet. Platelet is responsible for clotting of blood and it stops bleeding. This is the function of platelet. Now let's recap. So blood is a red fluid that runs throughout our entire body. Different components of blood are plasma, red blood cell, white blood cell, and platelets. Plasma is a liquid part of the blood that carries nutrients, blood cells, and different hormones. Red blood cells has a special pigment called hemoglobin, which carries oxygen throughout the body. And white blood cells help the body to fight the infection and platelets are responsible for clots and hence healing wounds.